or he will be died. That is not a proper report. It should say something specific. So we have to take a design and model, and we have to make the model to work for our desired and ambitious and prolonged goal of our life or the system or of our tradition. So we have to design a model that is known as triple C model. What is triple C model? The first C is collective survival. To get a collective survival, we have to have a composite task force value. To get a composite task force, we have to have a common merge. We cannot merge with all people. You must have a common merge. Somebody told today about increasing the quantitative strength. How to make common merge? It can be made only with people, those who are having three things. One is similarity. What is similarity? Homo heterogeneous, hetero homogeneous, and heterogeneous. These things are similarity. Those who are like us and with us, they are homogeneous. Those who belong to our own tradition but different in some aspects, they are homo heterogeneous. Those who are different from us, they are practicing something which is similar and proximate to us, they are hetero homogeneous. Those who are totally different from us, they are heterogeneous. First we have to start with homogeneous affinity, then homo heterogeneous affinity, then hetero homogeneous affinity, then we can also embrace the heterogeneous people and create the quantitative strength. It is a proper way which has been given by our shastras, our tradition. Unless we do these things with the similarity, and they must have two more qualities, compatibility and flexibility. There are three things, religions or civilizations, there are institutions and persons. There may be personal conflict, there may be institutional conflict, there may be religious conflict. In some areas, religion is better, but the institution is worse or the person is worse too. In some areas, the person may be better, but the institution, religion, they are totally against us. So we have to see where it can be compatible, where persons are flexible, and we have to make the quantitative strength. Then, if you make persons, that is quantitative strength, if you make the integrity, that is qualitative strength, if you create resources of finance and wisdom, that is effective strength, if you make it in the society with the youngsters and budding generations, that is executive strength. These are all the four pillar model which we are going to do for our society. And whatever the future we are going to face, we are going to have the same repetition of the reasons what we have been given by Dr. Gerard Diamond. He has given some research. Why the religions or civilizations have been put into declination? Number one, because of environmental conditions. Number two, climate changes, social conditions, inner and external violences, and social response of multivarious activities and factors acting on them. These are all the reasons. Now we are having same problems, similar problems, and even serious more problems. Now we have to face the same thing. And we have to go on a scientific research. Scientific research means we have to go for fiscal demographic studies, historical dynamics, social macro dynamic structure. Like that, we have to go for a scientific research and come for the contemporary level. Contemporary level, there are four statements which are there vociferously being shouted in all corners. Alliance between civilizations, dialogue between civilizations, and how to create a pluralistic society in harmony, and what is multiculturalism. It has been shouted by a lot of people, but that is mere enthusiasm or eyewash service. It is not being practically maintained because of three major forces which are governing a person's emotion. One is a spark, second is a sprit, third is a stock. If you have stocked something here for your program today, you will just vomit the stock and go away. The stock thing is a political announcement or just a stage declaration. Those who are having a sprit, those who are having a spark, those who are having a sprit can enlighten thousands of people. Those who are having a spark, they can get enlightened. So this is more than the UN dialogue between civilizations I could see, because I have been seeing here not stocks, but sharp, shrewd, soft, and spiritually potential, radial, brilliant, effulgent sparks, as well as the sprits I could see here. Certainly it will mature more than what the other associations have been claiming that they will do. And moreover, there are two problems in the society with the so-called admirers of Reformation. The first problem is they cannot create five things. One is impact. What is impact? If they talk with somebody, they can create some sort of methodology to fill their ears, not minds. That is influence. How far they can influence the members of the society, they cannot do that. Third thing is erudition, knowledge precision. They cannot do, because they can give only superficial survey, peripheral survey, prosaic survey, not intensive survey, perspicacious survey, clairvoyant survey, futuristic contemporary survey. They cannot give. They will give only peripheral thing or even prejudicial. Somebody told that regarding the Australian natives, somebody have made a book which was full of prejudicial view. Like that, they will have only prejudicial and anti-realistic or anti-veritable statements, far away from the reach of reality, eternity, and truth. So this is what we are going. So we want real erudition, that the people, they don't have. They don't master the things and come. They just munch some things and just reveal the same things in the society. That is the third problem. Fourth thing, they are not reaching the grassroots. Lot of the people, those who are going to serve you, those who are suffering, those who make the mass of the society are not within this auditorium. How to make the grassroots? Number fifth, how to create an organizational hierarchy, not anarchy or monarchy, to create an organizational, mutually love-blended hierarchy to reach the society by means of organizers, well-wishers and patrons. This system is not there even with UN. I believe that hopefully after a decade, we could see a mega transformation and major renaissance in the society through such activities. This is the greatness that we are going to achieve. So this UN declaration, even they are not having these things. The second problem is, first I have told inability. The second problem is incongruity. What is incongruity? If something is not easily unitable, you must not try to unite it. If something is unitable, you have to unite it. So uniting things which are not unitable and not uniting things which are ready to unite is the problem of incongruity with the civilization. You cannot unite things with all. Distant things are different from different things are different from distinct things, distinct are things are different from dangerous things. For example, milk and nectar, they are different from each other. Milk is different from nectar. Water is different from nectar. And ambrosia is distinct from nectar. Amrita is distinct from nectar. And poison is also different from water, but you must not say that it is different. It is dangerous. So milk is also different from water, poison is also different from water, nectar is also different from water, but the grades are different. So those who are readily acceptable, embraceable, those who cry and call for unity and social development and global development to create a global village and to create a harmonious society, such people, they have to be searched and embraced. That thing was not there with these people, because of this we are getting all of these problems. And coming to the society, civilizations, falling of civilization, risings are totally inevitable, inescapable. Because manifestation, consolidation, permeation, absorption, contribution, upgradation, modification, domination, these things are unavoidable in the development of any society or civilization. Our domination is also that is entirely different. There are four dominations. One is promulgative domination of missionaries, invasive domination of coercive religions, we are having benevolent domination. Fourth thing is a political or societal domination, where you have to embrace the religion or customs without which you cannot survive there, as if it is there in some countries. So these are all the various dominations. We have our own benevolent domination to penetrate in the society. And there are five status of civilization now. One is fusion. So many religions, they have fused with other religions and they are not traceable. Second thing is fall, that which is in declination. Third thing is fragile, that religions which are endangered. Fourth is flourishing, like our religion. Fifth thing is forceful and ferocious religions which are there in domination. So we have to understand the mind setup and social setup along with our own setup. We have to understand both proponent as well as opponent. Proponent, his component, opponent and his component, then only we can have a real combat, real debate, without which we cannot do in the society something productive and long-lasting. Apart from our speeches, we cannot contribute anything in executive service. So coming to the conclusive session, I want to say that it is a proper time, it is a proper topic, it is a proper methodology, everything is proper, and we have to work on the basis of what we have started now. And coming to the final session, in which I want to give some ideas, four or five ideas, how to proceed with according to my mind, my limited mind or caliber, I want to present it here. Number one, as the society is having different type of approach models, number one is liberalism, I don't want any religion. Conversion. Conversion is also of three types. Some people, they are averse to conversion. They don't want anybody to get inside their religion, like Zoroastrians. They are preserving chastity. Some people, they cannot sleep unless they convert a dozen of people per hour. And some people, they are so intolerant or so magnanimous that they cannot see an opponent in the pathway. Even a common pathway, they don't want to see such a person. So conversion is like that. Conversion is either not to allow a person, not to allow a person inside the religion, one. Not refraining from the process of continuously allowing or dragging the persons inside the religion, number two. Number three, it is a way in which no other person is tolerated in the society, this conversion. Liberalism means I don't want any religion. Chauvinism means extremism and fundamentalism, I want only my religion. Secularism is of two types. One, all religions are equal. Second is pseudo-secularism, in which there is unilateral concession and indulgence. That is in secularism. The fifth thing is our religion, that is altruistic idealism. I want to give 3 points. If you see somebody from any part of the world, that I feel really, I talk from my heart. It is not by any preparation or by anything.